Crib session where we are going to talk about the latest MSIX enhancements from Advanced Installer team, along with some nice valuable tips and tricks on MSIX packaging. This being my first time when I attend this great event, let me introduce myself first. My name is Horatiu Vladasel. I started my career as an application packager at IBM Romania. That was about 10 years back. And since then, I have been involved in quite a few migration projects, from Windows XP to Windows Vista, and then Windows 7. That was quite a big hassle. I wouldn't want to go through that again. From Office 2010 to Office 2013, and then Office 2016, 365. From Internet Explorer 8 to Internet Explorer 11, quite a big jump. And now the project which I'm currently working on is from Windows 7 to Windows 10, and in the same time from AV4 to AV5, and where I lead the application packaging team, and I'm also the escalation point for urgent and critical application. And because I brought Windows 7 into discussion, as you might be aware, that Microsoft will end the support for Windows 7 on 14th of January 2020. And the time seems to be quite tight now. There are only few months left. I really hope we'll be able to meet this deadline on the project I'm currently working for. Otherwise, I may risk a pay cut or even worse, to be kicked out. Anyway, I'm also the founder of MSIX Packaging User Group UK. The main aim of this group is to bring together IT professionals all over the world and to share knowledge about this new technology. In the same time, I am a technical advisor at Advanced Installer. This product was released in 2004, and what you might not know is it all started as a tool for software developers, but the tool itself has been developed a lot along the time, at the moment being successfully used by both software developers and application packagers like myself all over the world in their day-to-day work. Either you are talking about AV4 or AV5, MSI, Apex, or even MSIX, they are all supported in the Advanced Installer. For those who missed the news in 2008, Advanced Installer was the official release, MSIX release partner for Microsoft, and since then, based on the feedback we've got, we were the Microsoft partner with the most powerful MSIX support. That's all about myself. I don't want to bore you with other things about me, so let's move next into something more interesting. MSIX, I assume that all of you are aware about what MSIX is. Have you had the chance to play with it? Cool, that's good. And that's Microsoft statement from MSIX doc, and this is how they describe this new technology. Safe, secure, reliable. Now let's try to go through each of these and presumably give a few explanations why they consider this to be safe, secure, and reliable. Why safe? So it can be considered safe because MSIX, same as AV, runs inside the container, and this will prevent any potential conflicts between applications. In the same time, running inside the containers open the door for smooth uninstall and upgrade of the package. Secure, well, starting with MSIX, Microsoft introduced code signing certification as mandatory for all their packages in this format. In simple words, you cannot install a package if it's not digitally signed. Reliable, not quite there yet, because MSIX comes with a few limitations, and therefore not really ready to be fully adopted by enterprises. Hopefully, Microsoft will address all this, and we will all be there shortly. However, as a company, if you want to be on top of things and take benefits of full benefits of modern application, then presumably you might want to give this a try sooner rather than later. Eventually, assess all your applications and see which ones are a good candidate for MSIX. Moving next. Seconds. Now let's try to put both AV5 and MSIX on the same page and see what's same and what's different between these two technology on a high level. So first thing first, both of them rely on container technology, and as I said earlier for MSIX, but it's applicable for both AV and MSIX. This allows smooth uninstall and upgrade of the package, and in the same time, it prevents any potential conflict between application. However, MSIX uses a modern app container in order to get access to Universal Windows Platform API and provide user with modern and engaging Windows 10 experience, such as live tiles, notification, etc. Bear in mind that MSIX is aimed to be the packaging format for both Win32 and Universal Windows Platform applications. Another great benefit of containerized application is that all their files, all the necessary files, either stay within the container or follow precise, predictable rules about where those files may live on the system. When you uninstall, all the data goes with the program. What this means, you will have a cleaner operating system going forward, and you will never regret to install an application again. Code signing, well, as I said earlier, this was introduced as a feature, as a mandatory feature in MSIX. This is to ensure the integrity of the installer, and that's pretty much all about it. Moving next, scripting. So in AV5, you can use scripts to either bypass an AV limitation or to customize your package. as you all know, you can't have drivers, and because they run inside the kernel, and I'm sure that pretty much all of you have come across this challenge. The workaround for this is to create a PowerShell script which installs the driver. Add that PowerShell script along with the driver source file within the AV package and run it from a deploy.config.xml. Now, let's say you've got an application which install user configuration file, which in update folder, for example, which changes periodically. I'm pretty much sure you don't meet this kind of application for off-the-shelf software, or if you do, it would be very rarely. However, from my experience, each company, especially the big ones, have their own in-house built applications, which was developed a long time ago and are highly tailored in order to meet the business user needs. How would you approach such an application? Well, if you don't have an army of packagers or unlimited budget, you might want to package one single time. Yeah, create a script which take the user config file outside the package, create a script which put it somewhere on the share, create a script which copies from there locally to the device where the AV package will pick it up, and in this way you will avoid to repackaging over and over again when that user configuration file changes. Some of you might wonder why I put a check against MSI scripting. Well, for those of you who haven't checked MSIX package support framework GitHub page. Recently, MSIX scripting is now finally supported, and now you can add PowerShell scripts straight into your MSIX package. Going forward, let's now try to see what's the difference between AV and MSIX in terms of scripting, and let's start with AV4. I assume most of you have not used AV4 for quite a while now, neither I, don't worry. Let's try to look back together and see what option we had at that time when we had to put a script within the AV4 package. So we had an item called script timing and its corresponding event. So when we wanted to run a script within the AV package, we had the choice to either run it pre or post streaming, pre or post launching, or post shutting down of the AV package. In the same time, there was also an item called Protect, which told the client if the script should run inside or outside the virtual environment. Going next, AV5, as you can see straight, you can notice straight away, in AV5, we have much more flexibility when it comes to the time when we can run the script comparing with AV4. And before I forget, a good news here, Microsoft has just announced a few weeks back that they will extend the extend this support for AV4 until AP5, sorry, until 2026. However, don't confuse extended support with mainstream support. When a product is in extended support, no new feature will be added. It will be mainly only fixes. So as you can see, we have much more many options in AppV5. So you can run you can run your script either when the package is added or removed, published or unpublished, either when the virtual environment is started or terminated, or even either when the process itself is starting and terminated. In addition to AV4, in AV5 we also have dynamic configuration file, and here we have user-config.xml and deployment-config.xml. In deployment-config.xml we have two sections, machine configuration section and user configuration section. And pretty much similar as in AV4, we've got an item called run in virtual environment, which again tells the client if the script should run inside or outside the virtual environment. As you can see, there are so many options, so you must to be very careful when you consider all this and when you set your script, and also choose the event which triggers that script. Going next, MSIX. In MSIX, we've got only two events which we can use to trigger our script. That's the configuration item called start script. This means your script will be run before the execution of the package executable, and end script, you use this when you want your script to be executed after the package executable finishes. Again, exactly the same as in AV5, we have a running virtual environment configuration item, which again tells the client if the script should run inside or outside the virtual environment. Apart from this, we also got few others. What I want to tell you is that all of them are optional apart from script path, which is mandatory, and as its name says, yeah, it should contain the path to your PowerShell script. And MSI scripting, as it stands today, is fully integrated. It will be fully integrated into next release for advanced installer. However, for this presentation for today, I've succeeded to get hold of a demo version. Let's give it a try and see how we can play with MSIX scripting. So, for this demo, I choose a very simple application which contains only two files. It's about this executable and a configuration file. What the executable needs to do is to read the content of the configuration file, which is located in AppData. Let me build this package, and I will show in a minute how it behaves. It's done. So now, if we install this on the machine, yeah, if I press read text file, it will display the path of the configuration file. As you can see, is in local app data PS sample folder. And then that's the content of the configuration file. Yeah. One thing which I would want to show you here, yeah, because as I said earlier, MSIX packages run inside the container. So if I go to local update of my local update folder, I'm not able to see that PS sample folder in there. So that means everything is inside the container. Yeah. However, if I am to break within the MSI container, and for this I'm going to use this free tool from Advanced Installer. If you want to use it, feel free to download it. Yeah, and I will open a CMD file, and if I just trying to browse to my local AppData folder. Yeah. PS sample folder is there, and also my config file. If I'm open it, I can see that it has the same content as it is displayed by my application. So this is the package which I created. Now let's close all this, uninstall this version. Now, if we open this MSI package in Advanced Installer and try to add a PowerShell script for this demo session, what I did, I prepared a very simple PowerShell script, which all it does is to copy the file from a map drive to my local AppData folder and in their PS sample folder. So let's add this script into our existing MSIX package. And now let's configure it. Script path, it doesn't need to be the full path of the executable because my copy config file.ps1 is in the root folder and up there. Now I want the script to run inside the virtual environment. I don't want to stop an error. I don't want to run only once because I put these scripts to run when before the execution of the executable of the package executable, and therefore I want to run every single time I launch the application. So I set that run once to false. Show window. I want to for the testing purpose. I want the PowerShell window to be displayed just for one second so that I am sure that my script run in the background, and I want the PowerShell script to my application to wait for the PowerShell script to finish. So this is all set now. Well, before I go and save it, I need to resign this package again. If you remember, I said earlier that code signing certification will ensure that your package is the same as you've got from the vendor. Basically, is ensure the integrity of your installer. So let me sign this again and do a save as. Let's just name it -ps. That's it, it's all done. Now let me show you. So on my machine, as you can see here, I've got the W drive already mapped, and in there I have a new version of the config file, yeah, with a completely different content within it. Now if I am to install this new MSI package, which I just created and added that PowerShell script within it, my application should go and copy the new configuration file from the map drive locally within the MSIS container and read the new content from there. Yeah, as you can see, this is the new file. Even more, if I close it, if I go to WMAP drive, yeah, and just put here version 2 of the config file, save it, launch it again, read text file, the new configuration file has been copied from the MAD drive locally within the MSIX container, and the application was able to read it from there. That's all about PowerShell scripting for MSIX packages. Let's go back to our PowerPoint presentation. Here we have MSIX editor. Let's suppose you created an MSIX package like I did earlier for my PowerShell script. And then you quickly want to add something, you quickly want to edit that, or you just want to have a quick look through it. Well, this new feature in Advanced Installer allows you to directly open an MSIX package without to be needed to go and open our Advanced Installer project, for those of you who already use Advanced Installer. This new feature could turn to be quite useful in case you don't have an Advanced Installer project file for your application. Yeah, or even when your MSIX package, it was not created in Advanced Installer. So for example, if it was created in MSIX packaging tool. Yeah, you can take that MSIX package and open in advanced installer, do whatever changes you need, save it, and it will. You can use that one. This new fully dedicated graphical user interface for MSIX editor has not been supported until now. It will be starting with the next release of Advanced Installer, but as you already noticed earlier in my presentation, yeah, this new feature is there now. So all you need to do is to right-click on the MSIX package, select Edit with Advanced Installer. Oops, sorry. Yeah. 2 seconds, please. Yeah, so this is our MSIX package for the which we use for the earlier demo. If we right click on it, edit with Advanced Installer, it will open straight away. What you don't need to forget, if you remember from my demo earlier, yeah, once you open, the digital signature is gone, so you need to digitally sign it again. Otherwise, you won't be able to install it on install it and use it. Right, MSIX div. This is again a new enhancement which we are working to add it in the new release of Advanced Installer. But again, the demo version which I've got it has this new feature included. So. Let's now suppose we take the updated MSIX package, the one with the PowerShell script included into it, and try to have a quick peek inside it. This one. So what I want to tell you, same as AV, MSIX uses a PKZIP base file compression, and therefore it can be used, it can be decompressed using pretty much any PKZIP utility tool. Let me close this presentation. My favorite one is 7-zip. So if I decompress this MSIX package, which we just created earlier, and have the PowerShell script included into it. In there, you can find a bunch of files, one of those files being this appxmanifest.xml. The appxmanifest.xml is the file which contains all the info the system needs to deploy, display, and update your MSIX package. So if we open this in a text editor, Notepad, it doesn't really matter. Yeah, here you will see a bunch of details. Yeah, and for those who use advanced installer, you notice straight away that the target for the application executable has changed from psample.exe, that's the executable which I created and we used for the first version of the MSIX package in my previous demo, that's changed to aistab.exe. Aistab is an executable which we use it to take care of the PowerShell script and then launch your application. For those of you who use advanced installer, probably you are familiar with this because we also use it for package support framework. Now, let's say you've got this new package, yeah, the updating one with the PowerShell script included, and you want to compare this with the previous version. However, if you know what you are after, it's very simple. Like in my example, I know that the package executable had to change because I used the aistab.exe file to add my PowerShell script. But let's say it wasn't you who created the previous package, it was somebody else, maybe a colleague of you who left the organization or retired or whatever, and now you want to see what's the difference between two MSIX packages in terms of their Apex manifest file. So it will be an entire hassle if you decompress both of them and do a visual comparison of the Apex manifest file, or even if you decompress them and you use a comparison tool like BeyondCompare. Yeah, it's not a really straightforward process. So with this new feature, which you will get in our next release, what you can do is, sorry, not that one, edit in advanced installer. You can open one of the package in advanced installer. Yeah, and here, under application definition, you have MSIX diff page. If you go in here, browse, select the other one, yeah, and as you can see, it's nice and easy. You don't need to know all those details which are written in the Apex manifest.xml file. Yeah, whatever is different is highlighted for you. And as you can see, the catch here is you don't need to decompress anything. You can do everything straight from advanced installer. And with this, that was all from my side, because whilst we were outside and I was standing at the booth, some of you came to me and raised their concern about this this new technology, which is MSIX. My recommendation, our recommendation is, if you started your journey to MSIX, carry on. If you haven't, it's still not too late now. If you are on AV and if you don't plan to migrate to MSIX very soon, you are still safe, and you will also get all our support in order to convert your AV packages to MSIX. Hope you enjoyed this session, and hope you found it interesting and it caught your attention. Now, if you've got any questions, yes? Okay, cheers, thank you. Any other questions? Yep.
You mentioned that in the new versions of MSIX, it's possible to run PowerShell scripts prior to launching the executable and after launching.
Yes, that's right. No, at the moment, no. We don't, hopefully, because my personal opinion is, as it stands today, we might face some challenges from this point of view. I don't know what's Microsoft plan, if they plan to give us some more option, like you said, we had in AV5, yeah, we had the option to run the script when the package was added, removed, published, unpublished, when the virtual environment was started or terminated, or the process was started and terminated, so many in AV5. But yeah, at the moment, it's just these two events which you can use to trigger your script execution, start script and end script. Before the package executable start and after the package executable finish.
And the scripts are not supposed to require an evaluation, because I understand.
No. No.
They can be executed only with user profile.
Yeah. For this demo, I tried to put the configuration file in the app there, in the application directory, and yeah, what I got, it was an error that saying that access is denied. So, what will be in the, probably, yes, because there is no way around, or, yeah. Any other questions? Yeah.
Can I just point out this question? There is an option for one only once, so you don't have to build that logic in. So you can still do it as a start of application type of script, but it's only going to happen the first time for that user. So that really kind of gets you the deployment script option that you're probably looking for.
Thank you. Any other questions? No, nobody? Thank you so much for joining me and hope we'll see you soon. Thank you.